It was an honor to get beat by the world's best Big Brother player and the world's simultaneously worst trader all today. It was an honor, and I really appreciate it. I love him. Sorry, shot. I'm sorry, guys. I'm butthurt right now. I wanted to win that. I absolutely wanted to win that. I don't know. Like, how fair is it, though? How fair is it? Ohio State, Michigan. Actually, I straight up got. Like, I didn't. I was just like, I'm not going to call a defense to stop the flats. No, honestly, Dan doing no vig, his first. We're going to try and do some 799 runs, by the way, if you're just coming in. We're going to try and do some 799 runs. I should have played better. I know, I should have. I was like, I'm not going to try and stop anything in the flats here and just hope he stops running it. Because if I take a corner and commit him to that, he's going to be one-on-one with my safeties. And I don't know if Michigan has that personnel. More than one 799? Probably not. I mean, I'd be stoked just to get one. We're trying to do it the real way too, no skips. That's also key. Oh, sorry, dog. I think they're doing other rivalry games tomorrow. Yeah, I think they're doing other rivalry games tomorrow. I don't know. I'm not playing in tomorrow's. Yeah, I think that was the thing. I think all week they're doing different rivalries. And it makes sense. I mean, Michigan, Ohio State makes sense to do. Oh, that was stupid. Excuse me. Excuse me. Several 799. Whoa, I need that key. No, not several. I wish I was goated enough to do several in one day. No, usually how my Spelunky goes is I'll have a really great run right at the beginning of my day. Ooh, and then I'll have nothing but crap runs for the rest. How do I feel about GM being the 11th team? Well, I'm stoked it's an American team. I'm a GM kid, so I'm very pro that, all of that. My dad used to work for Cadillac, so cool on that. The only thing that scares me is I'm a Red Bull guy, and we have a Ford engine coming next year. Is it next year? I can't remember if it's next year or in 2 years, or we're going to change to Ford in 2026. And I don't think that's a good sign for us. Can't believe Dan's chat stormed the field. I know, I wasn't even ranked before going in there. I shouldn't even have been in there. How they stormed the field like that? Aston to Honda was interesting. I don't get why we would get rid of Honda. Like, that's the thing that I never understood. But it was also like Honda, it's, from what I understood, it's Honda was, said they were leaving. And then we were going with Porsche, and then we ended up with Ford. I don't know. I don't know how all that works. I also think it's pretty funny that Aston Martin, a car company, needs someone else's engine, though. I know that Cadillac won't be ready by then, you know? Sorry, guy, I need this. Too many bombs for me to leave. I need all the bombs. Yeah, I watched the Vegas race. Vegas is a good race. Mercedes has a good car when it's cold. Nah, I just missed them. Aston Martin's never made their own engines? No, not in F1. I just think that's funny, though. It's something I always think is funny. That, like, McLaren not making its own engines in F1 is a funny thing to me. Because, like, for those of you that don't watch F1, when you think of the name McLaren, you probably think of fast car. But they don't make their own engines. I know you. It's just not something you would think of. All right, let's go. Do I think it's gonna be hard for GM to find a good F1 driver? I mean, you gotta build a good car first, and then you'll get good drivers. If you have a good car, you'll get good drivers. I mean, no matter what, your worst case when you're an F1 team is you have your pick of any of the drivers that are, you know, pretty much 18th through the 50th best drivers in the world, so. Wow, that just caught me. Do the drivers matter? Oh yeah, but not as much as they matter in like F3 and F2. But yeah, the drivers matter, of course. But a driver can't get half a second of time in F1. Like, if everyone in F1 was put in the same car, there'd probably be like maybe a second between the first and last person. But it'd be pretty consistent who would finish first and who would finish last. A second elapsed a tremendous amount of time, but in a, yeah. Drivers matter, but they don't matter as much as having a, you gotta have a great car. The best driver can't overcome a bad car in F1, you know? Yeah, a good driver can win with a bad car, maybe not consistently, but like, yeah, a bad driver can't win. A bad driver can win with a great car, but not consistently still, you know what I mean? But at the end of the day, all of them are really, really f***ing good drivers, no matter what. They're all better than I ever will be. Ignore that. No notes. Yeah, against Dan, he was trying to goad me into running cover two the whole time, and I just refused. What do I want to do here? No, I just want to keep going. In hindsight, that was bad. You're a bit of an expert in F1 because you've watched one season of Netflix show. That's all you need. I tell you what, the Netflix show is more exciting than the actual season, so I understand. Actually, this season was f***ing awesome. Next season will be f***ing awesome too. Next season might end up being the best season ever. I thought I was dead right there. Whee! So many rookies next year? Yeah. Oh, I want him. All right, chat. Yeah, I'm gonna look you for a little bit. I kinda wanna Kaiser. We could Iron Mob a little bit, chat. We could do some Iron Mob. That was stupid. You want a 30 turn Mario Party? I got time. What's Wavy doing? You know I'm in Pineapple. I'm not gonna say no. Oh, got hit. Gunther got fired as Haas manager. We just killed our friend there, chat. Yeah. Well, if it makes you feel better, Haas is not better since they fired him, honestly. If anything, Haas is worse. All right, let's go. Yeah, Gunther's great. I mean, what makes F1 so much fun is the personalities, right? It just seems like, I feel like, one of the things I love about it is it's such a rich person, extravagant sport that is literally cut off to the ultra rich. Not just like fandom too, you know what I mean? Like going to an F1 race is an incredibly expensive endeavor. And I just think it's so funny. Like, I don't know, like the dichotomy between the ultra rich that partake in it versus like race car drivers and how they f***ing talk. And how at the end of the day, all race car drivers are kind of just rednecks. Dude, it's a soap opera with guys that are really good at driving cars. It really is. All right. We're fine. We're safe. Did I compare F1 to polo? I mean, I don't know anything about polos, so probably not. Hey, listen, bud. I'm gonna need you to just go ahead and take one for the team there. I mean, I feel like polo's not a real sport, though. In that, I feel like polo only exists for, like, rich people who are unathletic at everything else to have something that they can be slightly better at than their other rich friends. Like, I don't think polo... Like, I unironically think I could become a great poloer right now. F1 is basically wrestling, yes. Yeah, my toxic trait is that I think I would be good at polo today. I've never even ridden a horse. I think I'd be great at polo right now. What? Not water polo, no. Water polo, legitimately water polo seems like the hardest sport. Like to me, like water, there's no way I would have the endurance to play water polo. Like just watching the way they fight underneath, you have a friend that plays bike polo? That's, I feel like that goes hard. Oh yeah, I would be so dead tired if I did water polo. Chat, hear me out. I want to put a golf simulator in my garage. I've been talking about this for a while. And to justify it, I want to do a stream where I have to sleep in my garage until I get a hole in one. Is Wavy on stream right now? No, not Mario Golf. How big's my garage? Not big enough to have a car and a golf simulator. Yeah, and then I can write it off. That's basically the Barstool stream from a few months ago. Except I, again, really, really good looking. Can I actually golf though? I'm like a 90 golfer. I'm mostly like, I don't break 100, but I very rarely break 90. You know? Like, I'm in the 90s. Like, I never break 100 anymore. But I'm gonna have some breakfast balls, right? I was looking at chat. Oh my god, I wasn't ready. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. No, like, I shoot like 90. If we're keeping real score. But I'm a pretty chill with the rules golfer. Is this like Mario? It's exactly like Mario. Lunky's gonna lunk. That wasn't even a lunky though. That was just me being an idiot. Could you back the fuck up with that gun? If Mario was sadistic and didn't care in the slightest, oh shit! I'm dead. I'm dead. You feel like that's your fault? No, it's not your fault. I at least gotta get one into Cosmic Ocean. No, I'm not gonna get that guy. If you were a 6 handicap at your best and now you don't keep score, CJ's really good. Yeah, I'm painfully below good at golf, you know what I mean? Which I think everybody is. But either way, it'd be a fun stream. Oh wait, I need to bring him over there. Yeah, I never play. I play probably like three rounds a year. And then half of the time they're with Red Bull. They have a whole tournament set up where you play on the sim? I screwed up. Yeah, I have a buddy who's like a 3 handicap in my fantasy football league, and we golf like every year in fantasy, and I fucking hate playing with him. Is it easier to get hole-in-one in a simulator? Well, it's easier to get a hole-in-one if you're shooting 900 balls, you know what I mean? It's not really going to be a hole-in-one in the true sense of the word. Yeah. It technically won't be a hole-in-one. For semantics. That could still take like weeks. I don't know, I feel like if you're hitting enough balls at the same hole, like, you're just gonna get lucky at some point, right? I feel like if I'm hitting enough balls at the same hole, we'll get it. 2 days. A par 5. No, you don't use a par 5. The problem is, my idea was I would let chat like pay a certain amount of money and we would switch holes. That's where I think it would come in really hard. Yeah. You've lucked into a hole in one? I got a buddy that went out like his 4th time and clanged one off a pole. Off the f***ing flag. His 4th time out. Hate that motherfucker. It does come in really hard when you switch holes. I don't think you're talking about golf. Oh no, 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 no. Shit, I didn't mean to do that. Oh no, I killed him. Oh no. If your distance stays the same, the hole shouldn't matter. Well, like pin position would matter, things like that, you know? What green you're reading. Oh! Yeah, I feel like we need something that's like a buck 40, buck 50, you know? And make it happen. Oh, this is bad. This run's really bad. This is just, nothing good is happening in this run. Okay. Okay. All right. Okie dokie. Let's let something. Is it gonna fall anymore? Okay. It is falling. It freaked me with the okie doke. The seventh at Pebble? Which one's that? How many swings a day could you take before you get too tired? I don't know. These are all good questions, chat. I don't have the answer to any of these questions. I think that makes for a more interesting stream. I could have buddies come over. Yeah, I was gonna say, like, easily, I think like 300-400 swings a day is nothing, right? I don't think that's even remotely bad. Like in a 5-hour period, and then in like an hour break, 500 swings, an hour break, another 500, I think that'd be pretty doable. Getting 3,000 balls a day. 1,500 balls a day, sorry. Blisters will be a problem. Oh, I got f***ing rock hands. I'm joking, I have little baby girly hands. Yeah, I was gonna say, maybe glove both hands. Uh-oh. Poo two gloves. Mark it down. Mark it down. It's in my future plans. Future plans. Never doing a subathon again, but we'll do a hole-in-one-a-thon. My future plans to wear two gloves? Yes. Have I considered getting it first try? See, this is, that's the type of logic I've been going with. The non-hater logic. What is that? No what-a-thon? Alright, I don't know what that emote is. Alright, come on out, come on out. Oh shit. No, no surprise. Oh, surprise subathon? No. Absolutely not. Okay, could you fall down here, bro? No, I can't. I couldn't do a surprise subathon. It's greatly improved your game. Highly recommend. I mean, everyone I know says that. Like, okay, I am just like in a. Shoo! After all those shots, you have a better drive off the tee, right? And I'm horrible on par threes on the tee, you know? How did I survive? Skill. Lots and lots of games. Lots of fucking spelunky over time. No smush. Okay, we gotta pay attention. There we go, chat. Okay. Almost screwed that one up. Okay. Okay. All right. Yeah, you play a lot of Splunky 1. I don't think I've ever really played Splunky 1 or 2 without doing the shopkeepers, though. Like, I don't think I've ever done a game where I've not stolen from the shop. It just seems like there's so much stuff there. And it's free. You know what I mean? So I think if you do it enough, you just kind of... You know how they work. Because, like, also the shopkeepers have... Like, a react, like, they do the same patterns, right? So depending on if you're above them, below them, determines how they jump. When they're jumping, if they jump and shoot at the same time, they go higher. So, like, you can kind of goat them into going over things. Things like that. Yeah. Have I ever done the no money run? No. I don't know. I've never done no money. I've never done pacifist. And we're trying to do it the original traditional way. Yeah, no keeping it. How would you ever win pacifist? Well, you only kill like the bosses, I think. I don't even know how you kill the bosses. I tried high money run. No, those are so boring. High money runs are so boring. Can I just say that this fucking sucks? Oh, we got bees too? Ugh. You What is this fucking thing here? What is this shit? Where is the... Is it right here? Is this it? Where is the, Oh, I didn't get Van Helsing. Never mind. Never mind. Chat. What the f*** kind of exit is this? Or Van Horsing. Whatever his f***ing name is. Oh my god! I wasn't even paying attention to how much I had, health I had. I just assumed I had enough. That's fine. This is a-okay. This is not fine. Yeah, rip. Whenever. Yeah, only one Unk run, and you need it for this level right in here. Oh, shit. Kind of knew that was gonna happen. Yeah, now I can't do 790. Well, I might be able to, but I need a jetpack. Never mind. We're good. We're good. We're golden. Now I can do 799. Thank you for 25 months, my friend. Yeah, thank you for hanging out forever. And don't worry, Deathless Searcher. I know how long you've been here. It's okay. If I mean, being subbed for that long is just obnoxious anyway. It is. It is. I mean, you're just showing off then, aren't you? Two? One, probably not. Two, though, probably. But I'm pretty much always down. He's an addict. He's a fiend. Ow! I kind of want to reset. My man. Oh yeah, I do want to reset. I went too fast through that one. Oh, I thought that was death. Yeah, I didn't get the eye. What do you got here, bro? Okay. Turkey. You think, like, the only problem I have is that they just forgive you so quickly. But maybe it's because all the other guys don't have any other shoppers, so they're like, oh, well, I gotta forgive this guy. You know? Like, we can't alienate our own customer. Don't shoot the doggy. Don't you dare shoot the doggy. I need that key right about now. Shit. There we go. Have I gotten all the golden strawberries in Celeste? No. That worked. Didn't think I'd sneak through at that angle. Skills! God damn it. I know I didn't show them when I got my ass kicked. By Dan earlier, but skills, chat. Oh my god. Oh my god. He just got shot. Ooh. Orca. Did he pay me my 20 mil to throw that game? Dude, I would throw anything for $20 million. I'd throw my ass back for $20 million. I will throw it all back for you, chat, for $20 million. You kidding me? There's not one thing I don't know if I would do that's legal for $20 million. I do a lot of things for $20 million. Would I throw B? Dude, I throw B all the time. What do you mean? I throw him into pools. I yeet that kid. He comes in our room in the morning. Or if he's like sleeping in too late, I pick him up from his bed. I carry him into my room. And then I just fucking long toss him onto the bed. Yeah. Oh, dude, I'm throwing that kid around like he's a cat and I'm a Linity. He's a boy. I launched that little sucker. Like he owes me money? He does, dude. I pay for everything. You're right, not like Alinity. I tossed him way farther than she yeeted that cat, dude. Way farther. Okay. You bet I didn't feed him vodka, though? Not yet, but I tell you what, I will be the first. I promise you, no one's beaten me to that one. I will be the first. We're gonna have a nice long, once I get whiff of him trying it, I'm gonna teach him the ins and outs of how to not look like an asshole. How to be responsible in your consuming. If you could throw your cat, you definitely would. Okay, my absolutely horrid take is that I didn't think that girl throwing her cat was that big a deal. It was like over her shoulder, and cats always land on their feet. Yeah. Like, out of all the pets in the world to throw, gerbil worst. Cat, probably the best. Yeah, right? Gerbil, absolutely bad to throw. Don't throw a gerbil. But throwing a cat... Like over your shoulder like that? I thought the internet went a little too hard on that one. Yeah, I'll be honest. I thought a hamster, I'd have been like, no, you can't do that. He's in the little ball. You can't throw the little ball. Yeah, she like tossed it over her shoulder and the world was like, Usually I get it. Usually I'm like, yeah, they should apologize. But that one I didn't really understand. Do I think a flying squirrel would enjoy being thrown? I can't tell you which animals would enjoy being thrown or not. But I can tell you right now, I love being thrown. I feel like there's probably more than one lady in here that loves being thrown around a little bit. Throw me power, mommy. Ow! I need that dog now. Where's the dog? I'm gonna buy you, dog. I'm gonna take the dog. I'm taking the dog. I just kidnapped that dog. Now that's worse. Can you pet the dog? You can't pet the dog in this game, actually, honestly. I don't know why you can't. Whee! Link for this cat video? Oh, it's from like a decade ago. I'm not fucking looking up that. But I'll give you a link to a cat game where you can throw the cat all over the place and it's totally fine. Tell me more, Sarah. Go on. She threw you? Then what? Just out of curiosity. Then what? Then what? Yeah, then what happened? Mm-hmm. Go on. Just set the scene a little bit for me, too. Where were you? You know, what was going on? All right, 1, 2, 3, go. Can we all agree this mini game is the absolute bottom pit barrel of Spelunky? This is the worst thing in Spelunky. Wait, now really go on. I went from joking creepy to creepy creepy like that. Have I ever played Noida? Yes. I like Noida, but I don't love Noida. There's a lot of things I like. I like the whole pixelated like universe destroying thing in Noida. I don't like how Noida has like a bit of a break in the action. What is up with this fucking? Okay, f me, right? Holy f dick. Yeah, like when I'm doing a speedrun, that's what I'll do. But here I want to get all the money. I want the monies, Lebowski. I got lunkied there. Look on the bright side, you get to do the moon challenge again. It's just so slow and stupid, and there's no challenge in it. Whereas like every other challenge has like challenge, right? The moon challenge has no challenge. Goodbye, doggy. Just break the pickaxe with a push block? Sure, but it doesn't always work out that way. And also, it still doesn't change the fact that the moon challenge is no challenge at all. You're telling PETA on me? Yeah, the challenge is getting impatient, not getting crushed. Not looking at chat while you're doing it. That's the challenge. Oh, I'm gonna open these. That was my fault. Can you really say that when you've died at least once to the moon challenge? I have played UFO 50. I have not... I've only beaten like 5 of the games. I've played a lot of the games like halfway through. The problem I have with UFO video, I was saying, is just like, there's just some games I find boring. You know, there's just some games I can't really get into. They don't hook me right away. And I have a problem if like something doesn't hook me right away sometimes, like, eh. Go on. Go on. Sarah, it sounds like one of those nights that you'd love to recreate, but how do you do that? How do you talk anyone into that now? If you're addicted to Spelunky, does that make you a Lunky Junkie? Yes. But you're also, if you're really good looking, then you're a Hunky Lunky Junkie. I'll be here all week, chat. I'm sorry. You guys ready? Honestly, I haven't had a wild night in a long, like a really wild night. In a hot minute. The wonky donkey. There we go. Okay, sure. 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 That was just unlucky, chat. That's the shortest amount that you can fly on a thing. That was just unluck. Bad luck. I was skillful right there. That's how the telepack always ends. It does always end like that, honestly. Ooh, shit. No. No, no, I need that. No, I need it. No. Okay, well, I only have this then. That's fine. I wanted them both. That's okay. This is all we need. Love is all we need. Yeah, I wish the telepack was not guaranteed death, but okay. I'm gonna go rob you, bro. Sorry, man. Went from a speed run to a regular run back. Yeah. The telefrags are funnier. Oh, that was not it. Could you guys shoot each other, maybe? Could you guys shoot each other? Yeah. If you guys could shoot each other, that would be golden. Oh God. Yeah. How do you even have air so far down in a mine? Oh, this is on the moon. Yeah, this mine's on the moon. I would say like it's the hardest achievement in gaming that's like in a regular game, right? That's just like a regular ass game. Like it's not, you're not imposing any sort of challenge upon yourself. I think it's the hardest in gaming, honestly. Yeah. What about in the first game? Well, you don't go that far down. I mean, you do go all the way to hell, actually, in the first game. To be fair. Never use the jetpack? Oh, the jetpack's the literally greatest fucking item you can have. Yeah. It's the best, it's the goat item in the whole game. Brother man, why were you not moving? Incredibly good, just flammable. It is. You just gotta not, but here's the thing. If your jetpack's gonna blow up, you're dead anyway. That's my logic. If your jetpack's catching on fire, you were gonna die no matter what. Now you're just dying in a flashier way. No, I mean, cape's good, but jetpack's better, yeah. Jetpack in Volcana is dangerous, but... Oh no. I forgot to... Okay, this is a problem. I forgot to get the key. That's fine. It's not ideal. But that motherfucker is about to jump down here. Yeah, I just totally forgot that thing. I don't know what I was doing. Move, 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 move. Or I gotta be careful. Okay, I really gotta be careful. God damn it. What am I doing? Excuse me, I'd like that money. Okay, we have got to be careful. Was there an altar in that level? I don't remember it. Right at the start? Oh, I should have went back up. Definitely should have went back up and taken those guys. Oh, I did give it a turkey. I know, I should have given him the homies. Everyone shut up. Everyone in chat, shut the fuck up. Oh my God. At least we didn't blow up. Blowing up would have been a fine, acceptable experience. What's he doing? Making mistakes. Look like a skill issue. It was definitely a skill issue. I'll admit that. That was such a beginner move. Oh, what's the command? What is it, fall? It was a beginner move. It was my fault. Oh, the ricochet of the thing? Actually, I don't feel that bad about that one. Whoops, that's not what I want to do. Oh, hey. Hello. Why hello? I'll be back. I need some more money. That's not good. Hey, we're not getting there. No eye unless I get ropes. Oh. Chat, you're gonna pretend like I didn't have that plan the whole time. Poor. Stuff broke. I was on it the whole time. I knew we were in no worry. I just knew we had, oh shit, I didn't see that spider. I knew we had nothing to worry about. I still think we should go Volcano. Wait, we beat UConn today? I didn't know if we would win or not. I saw we were winning. Suck it, Dan Hurley. Suck at defending national champs. Now if only we can get in the playoffs for football. Playoffs? Yes, I'm talking about playoffs, chat. You know what? I'm gonna bring you along. One with a crazy shot at the end. I'm excited for the highlights then. Can't wait. Can't wait. Oh, I'm dead. I'm dead. Yep, I'm super dead. God damn it. Yeah, the ghost shark came. The hired hand just watch? Dude, they're such worthless pieces of fucking ass. Those guys, the boomerang guys in 799 are lethal. Where's my thing? There it is. 30 seconds while you lose. Oh my god, it's the worst. I love this game. I'll never stop playing this game. Okay, sure. That's fine. Yeah, I'll play this game probably like once or twice a month, every month for the rest of my life. One of my favorite games ever. I just think it controls very good. I like that it's always random. Shit's fun. I'll stop playing it when Spelunky 3 releases. I don't think we'll ever get a Spelunky 3, dude. Yeah, I think Spelunky 3 is not possible. I do not think that is happening. Although I'd be like, is there secrets in this game? This whole game's secrets, but I mean, they're not secrets anymore, not to me. But yeah, that's one of the big things for Spelunky is just the amount of secrets. Correct, they'll skip right by to Spelunky 4. Dude, I would kill for a sequel to this game. I would love it. Yeah. I just don't think he's gonna make another one. I don't know. Yeah, I don't think that there's much chance of him making another game. I guess it's not possible, but I don't know. I just feel like Derek Yu is going to build something different next. Yeah, I mean, he was working on UFO 50 before this even came out. Yeah, they started working on UFO 50 towards the end of this. And shit, that was 4 years ago. Spelunky 1, the gap between Spelunky 1 and Spelunky 2 was like 8 years or 10 years. Yeah, so. I mean, I just don't see it happening. He's probably done all he wanted with the idea. That's what I would speculate, but I mean, I personally feel like there's definitely room for one more game in this genre. But it would just have to be so big. I think that's also part of the problem too. To like make a third one, it would have to be outrageously large. Like branching paths in every direction. Oh shit. Hire you? For what? You're gonna make us a new Spelunky? To make my game? My cat game? What's your skills? What do you do? What up, Chris? Oh, that's not a good idea. That's a very bad idea. Okay. Okay. Come with me. Come on. Come up here. Get up here. Come on, buddy. Come on. I like how they don't go all the way. They're like, no. Okay, there's nothing over there. Shit. Okay. Dude, the frog monsters are the worst. They're the literal worst things in the game. Because they're only in one world. They pop up out of nowhere. That was my fault. I just stood there. He didn't. God damn it. They're salamanders, not frogs. What's the difference between a salamander and a frog? You don't know? Oh. Well, very helpful. Yeah, what's a salamander got going on? I don't know if I've ever seen a salamander in real life. They're like lizards? The difference between Quagsire and Politoed? See, now that I understand. That I fucking understand. I'm just dicking around right now. The bad guy in Monsters, Inc. What I don't get is that kid was a dick in college. He never grew out of it? I feel like they should have had a different bad guy in college for Monsters U. Is anyone gonna see Moana 2 this week? Anyone gonna go see Moana 2? You're seeing it tonight? Are you hyped? Everyone with kids? I know, I was thinking about taking my kid Thanksgiving morning. Moana 2 and Gladiator 2 double feature? I guarantee you Moana 2 is better. Actually, I don't know if Moana 2 is going to be better. It might be ass. I really don't know where they can take the journey anymore. But I do love Moana. Yeah, I was a little surprised they were making another Moana. It felt like Disney was like separating themselves from the Moana actress too, because she kind of like went through her teenage crazy years. And they were like, nope. I wish the actress was going to be in the live action Moana. Like, I get them doing the live action Moana. That I understand, you know? Don't have to hire writers. Scripts in. Yeah. And I get The Rock being Maui in live action Moana. I literally don't think you could hire anyone else besides The Rock to play that particular role. Oh, Moana 2 was supposed to be a TV show originally, and they just made it a movie. He's gonna look like the Scorpion King. Any other Hawaiian? Can you name another Hawaiian with box office star power that also is a gigantic muscle head? That's all I'm saying. There was only one option. He literally sings the songs. Jason Momoa? He's not really ripped though. He's just kind of fat now. Troy Polamalu? Does Troy Polamalu act? And also, Troy Polamalu is not that big a dude. Dog the Bounty Hunter? Honestly? He's been in a ton of Old Spice commercials. Oh yeah, that's fair. He has been in Old Spice commercials. Ooh, Troy Polamalu? No, Troy Polamalu's not dead. Samoa Joe? Whoa, where'd my ropes go? Someone burnt my ropes. Wait, is Samoa Joe Hawaiian and not Samoan? Also, I don't think Dog the Bounty Hunter is Hawaiian. But I guess The Rock is also Samoan. Yeah, you're right. The Rock is also Samoan. Wait, who's in the Moana commercial? Dog the Bounty Hunter? Troy Polamalu? Oh. Wait, when is he in the Moana commercial? The new one? Chat, we're not even making good attempts here today. With The Rock? I will say, I probably like The Rock more than most straight men, though. Yeah. Isn't Dog the Bounty Hunter dead? That I couldn't tell you. I thought the new Minecraft movie trailer with Jack Black, like, ever since I was a kid, I yearned for the mines. That trailer was really good. Compared to the original trailer, which was ass. I thought that trailer was funny. I thought it was good. If you start the ball in hell, the bar in hell, yeah, but you only get one chance to make a first impression. And in today's day and age of internet, sometimes first impression's it. You're corny, you know what I mean? Like, there's nothing that's gonna stop your corniness from ending. You can't get rid of the stench of corny. You know what I mean? There's a Spelunky TV show. Yeah, I agree, I thought the second trailer looked really good. The Shadow the Hedgehog trailer? I haven't seen that. Yeah, I thought second Minecraft trailer was significantly better. Well, I am a late in life embracer of corny. It took me a long time to realize that people that are corny as fuck are super happy comparatively to people that aren't. Yeah, I didn't recognize their game. The strength of their game. Wait, Dog the Bounty Hunter is not dead? Stop spreading misinformation here, people. The internet is not a place for misinformation. Gosh! There's gonna be a Spelunky episode of that Amazon series. Yeah, I'm pretty hyped for that. Yeah, stop gaslamping us into thinking Dog the Bounty Hunter's dead. How old's Dog the Bounty Hunter in human years? Wonderful question. Iron Cirrus, thank you for the Twitch Prime. Give me all your subs. Oh, wow. Just watch that man die. Wait, there's an episode on Concord? They did a whole episode on the game that doesn't exist anymore? Awkward. And they never even, honestly, Concord is a game that I feel like they never even tried to, like it had no chance from the get-go. Okay, we're gonna, oh wait, this is a bad idea. I just realized why that was a bad idea, chat. Dog the Bounty Hunter's wife died? Spreading misinformation. Oh, wait, hold on. On the Bounty Hunter. Why would we care if she died? This is really morbid, but as a streamer, I think about, like, okay, so, like, what if I died, right? And I think about, like, it'd be, like, over in, like, a day, right? Yeah. He's 71 years old and alive. Didn't his second wife die, too? Anyone that's had two people die under mysterious circumstances, I get a little nervous about. Just will all my viewers to DGR. I wonder if I can leave my chat name to my son. And he can take it over like Batman. Oh my god, that thing just murdered that dog. I need that jizz. Train AI on my VODs and then just pretend it never happened. Don't get me wrong, I'm sure I'm gonna get somewhat replaced by AI, but I don't think AI could have the absolute fucking bangers that I have of jokes. I mean, just absolute stunners with incredible quick-witted timing. This is AI right now. Oh, I have climbing gloves? I knew that. Yeah, this is already AI. Lame. I didn't realize I had climbing gloves, chat. Okay, come on. Come on. Listen, just because I have strong feelings about Wilt Chamberlain scoring 100 points, people bring it up all the time. It's the thing people use to get me angry. Who is people? I don't bring it up. Did I just bring it up? You just brought it up. You literally just brought it up, and now you're blaming me? Did I just get fucking hit by... Wilt Chamberlain? Okay. The famous story of Wilt Chamberlain is that he scored 100 points in a game, right? I don't believe that Wilt Chamberlain ever scored 100 points in a game. I think it is a lie fabricated by the world. We have plenty of footage of Wilt Chamberlain's games, but no footage of that. No radio calls of the game. Nothing. Okay? Beyond that, what I think happened is that a score... In a time and age where everyone's smoking cigarettes and in the gym and everything, I think an official score just didn't have anything to do and just was like, fuck, Wilt scored a lot of points. I lost track. And he just fucking hit 100. Not 99, not 101, just like a perfectly round 100. Wait, did I forget the crown? Right? This poor free throw shooter, historically mediocre free throw shooter, shoots like 49 free throws and hits all of them. Where'd the crown go? I just think it's too nice and perfectly round number. Cigarettes cause mass hysteria. It sounds like I'm being a hater. Listen, I have to provide a video for every goddamn 15th place speedrun I've ever done. Okay? And that motherfucker just held up a sign that said 100 and we all believe him. That's all I'm saying. No, I also don't believe he slept with 100,000 women or 10,000 women or whatever his thing was. And I absolutely will say that Kobe Bryant's 81, and I'm the biggest Kobe hater. You'll never find a bigger Kobe hater than me. His 81 is significantly more impressive than Wilt's 100, regardless. Oh, I'm a big Kobe hater. Yeah. I'm the Kendrick Lamar of Kobe Bryant. What do you mean? I watched his 81. We all watched it. That's a lot easier. Man out here dead and you're hating on him?
Who has Kobe beef?
Let's go.
Did Kobe Bryant just carbon me? Did Kobe Bryant just fucking carbon me? Did I just get Kobe Bryant from the dead? The 81st death of the day?
Let's go.
Thank you, Seti says go.
Sounds like someone got lung.
Thank you, TSP. It was the ghost of Kobe. We all saw it happen. Yeah, I'm a giant Kobe hater though. Giant. But I do miss watching him play basketball. Liz, yeah, look, I literally have an emote named after him. Come on. Do I think LeBron's better than Kobe? Oh, it's not even a shadow of a doubt. There's no doubt that LeBron James is better than Kobe. Yeah. I don't, we're not even having a debate. The debate should be, was Kobe Bryant better than Tim Duncan? And the answer is no. That should be the debate. And the answer is still no. I mean, technically didn't commit crimes, was accused of crimes. Historically, he's innocent of those crimes. Is Kobe Bryant better than Adam Sandler at making movies? Nah, I mean, I just want to be real about that. There's a difference between it, okay? That's all I'm saying. That sounds amazing, honestly. Is Steph Curry better than Tim Curry? The guy from Mr. Cooper? No! Who's the GOAT? Shaq or Jordan? It's not Shaq. There's legitimately only one debate about who is the greatest NBA player to ever live, and that's Michael Jordan versus LeBron James. And I think what you're really debating is what is more important. Playing at a ridiculously high level, around 90% of your peak for 20 straight years, or your peak being the peakiest. So, I don't know. I think they're both probably 1A, 1B, in my real opinion. Shaq could have been the greatest player of all time. He absolutely could have been, but... he prioritized lots of things over basketball, which is totally fine. I think a lot of humans should prioritize things over basketball. I think there's plenty of athletes that could be better humans while being maybe a slightly worse player. Tim Curry? What is this Tim Curry love? Who is Tim Curry? Prime 1v1 scenario? What do you mean? What's the rules of this 1v1? Like, most 1v1s played two dribbles. Is Shaq winning two dribbles? Probably not. Yeah, what's the rules of one-on-one here? Yeah, I don't think Shaq would beat Jokic in one-on-one. I don't think he'd beat Tim Duncan either. Orlando Shaq could. Orlando Shaq's not the best version of him. Orlando Shaq was probably the third best. Why do I keep thinking Tim Curry is the guy from Hanging with Mr. Cooper, chat? That's Mark Curry. Cooper, hanging with my man, he's a soul. Clue in Home Alone 2. Is he the toy store owner? Oh, the hotel manager, but he's a dick in that movie. Imagine how bad of a hotel manager you gotta be to kick out a child. No, the bellboy was, oh my God, what's his name? His daughter hates him. His daughter, the singer, hates him. Why do I know that and I can't think of his fucking name? Male Gigolo. Schneider. Rob Schneider. Rob Schneider. Go to play. You saw him do stand up once. He was pretty funny. Ah! I feel like a lot though, like, okay. I feel like when I'm at a comedy show, I think the person's funnier than they actually are when I'm actually physically there. The drinks help? Yeah, I think you feed off the crowd. Like, y'all ever watched a funny movie alone? You don't laugh the whole time. You might think it's funny, but you don't laugh. You know what I mean? God, he's got to be dead now, right? Hey, I don't think I laugh if I'm, like, watching a funny movie alone. Like, I think I need someone to feed off their laughter most of the time. Less comedians are less funny than I think they are. I've always wanted to try stand-up comedy, but I feel like it's also like it would be the hardest place to bomb. Like, I bomb a stream like once a week, right? Whatever. Go back and do it. But like stand-up, I feel like that would hurt my soul. Stand up so much harder than people think. Dude, 5 minutes of jokes is so many. Once a week? Are you saying I have more bad streams a week? Double Cube, you're like my best donator every month. Are you doing it out of pity? Stop it. Stand-up confidence is another level of confidence. Also, like, all stand-up comedians seem like dicks in real life. This is true. They all seem like fucking assholes. I feel like I can count on my one hand the ones that don't feel like fucking assholes. Stand-up comedians basically do nothing but bomb for 5 years, so they figure it out. I mean, it took me 2 years of streaming before I figured it out, I think. Honestly, I don't even think I ever figured it out. I just caught viewers. I just finally got viewers. You bet Louis Anderson's a nice guy? All right, we're gonna bring these back up. Jeff Foxworthy? I don't know. I feel like I've heard some shitty Jeff Foxworthy stories in the day. Didn't he sue a bunch of people? Didn't he sue the guy who actually came up with his joke? Louis Anderson's dead? Well, probably because he was an asshole. Kyle Kinane seems like a good guy. Dan Soder seems all right. I feel like as a comedian though, like even if you're like a genuinely good guy, you're still gotta be somewhat of an asshole. Like, right? Because you have to make fun of the world. I just don't know if you can get away with it. Oh yeah, see, finding out people died in stream sucks. Yeah, I feel like, okay. I feel like doing stand-up's definitely very, 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 very fucking difficult. Hey, guys. Okay, we got the crown. Nice. I mean, yeah, it took me 2 years to learn how to stream. Wait, Flo did stand-up comedy after his subathon? during a subathon? And it looked like he was gonna, was he on, was he, did he like do the set on stream? I would have you guys help me write it. You know what I mean? I would definitely have you guys help me write it. Holy fuck. This is bad. I did a roast on in GTA, and I had chat help me write it, and it was gold. Honestly, that roast was funny, chat. The roast was good. That was fun. I wish I had clips of that. A roast seems easier to pull off than normal stand-up. Well, I think what's, like, a really good roast, they get so insanely personal. On a really good roast that it, I feel like it does have a bit of easierness to it. Because you can just say, like, all the really mean things you've said about your friends in private. We roasted Moon Moon's character, the cop, Moon Moon's cop character. We roasted him, and we made a bunch of jokes about him looking like he does drugs. And then we made a few jokes about, like, the people in the crowd, you know? I need to find that. I don't think I have that VOD. I think that's lost to the ages. I think a roast is probably almost easier. Like, I think roasting a famous person you don't know is probably the easiest. I don't know if it's on my YouTube. Lenny Hawk, yeah, that's who it was. I don't remember what we said, but I remember the best joke was, a lot of people don't know this, but Lenny Hawk was born with a silver spoon in his mouth. Unfortunately, it had a lighter underneath it. And that was a banger. See? See? Right? See? That's fucking funny. I need to add that in. How would I add that into my normal comedy set? That's the only joke I got, chat. That's the one joke I have for my comedy set. Banger, though. Find someone else to apply it to. Yeah, I don't know. I need someone famous enough to apply it to. Famous and not sad. Easy to make a character that probably exists in my real life. Done. The problem is, I only got that's one. I got one joke. I didn't even fill a full 30 seconds. You just hit jump and pickaxe at the same time. Yeah. It's a segue in storytelling. Well, listen, I love a good throwback. Chat knows that. I get the idea of how you write a set. You make some jokes, have a really big story joke in the middle. And then the last thing you do is bring everything back to that original story joke. Hey, buddy. I hope I beat all the levels too. Well, I guess I don't need to get rid of this. I guess I can just go since I'm gonna hit myself. Because I would just waste it otherwise. You're so sad the daily doesn't work on Switch? I think the daily just doesn't work on Switch. Yeah. I just think the Switch doesn't have the dailies. I didn't do the torch challenge because I was poisoned, so it was just gonna take my thing. Yeah, I was already poisoned. It sucks, but... You think a roast is harder? Hey, what?
Do you need anything before I go to jiu-jitsu?
Nope. Okay. Love you. I need a jizz right there. Aren't most people celebrity roasts friends of the celebrity? I mean, I think depending on the roast. I don't think Jeff Ross knows all those people, no. I don't think Jeff Ross and Tom Brady are hanging out. But I think some of them are. Some of them are just comedians. Mean and funny is harder. Well, I think like when you get in those roasts, a lot of those roasts though, like they're really popular roasts. Like the Tom Brady roast, they were just mean. You know what I mean? There was just mean in there. Yeah. Just mean in that side, that one. I don't need anything in here. To be fair, Tom Brady doesn't have many friends. Well, I don't know about you, but a lot of my adult friends come because my wife keeps in touch with them. And he recently got divorced. Gronk's the only friends anyone needs. I will say Gronk seems like a really fun friend. You know? Like, he does seem like one of those guys that's like... You gotta have a guy in the crew that's just like... down. You know what I mean? That kind of... Holy God. That kind of pushes you along. Am I in a new house? No, I'm not in a new house. I literally just moved my stream room around. That's it. Holy shit. Ugh. Oh shit, I'm glad I came up here. Oh god. Items. What do we need here? We need a cracked servant of jade marked by the snake. Cracked green snake. I thought it was on the other side. Wait. How did I not know that? I thought I did that earlier. I thought I literally did that exact move earlier. The fuck? Derek didn't need to program that in? I feel like a fucking idiot. Ah! First time name? It's crazy how there's always new ways to die in this game.